This week, President Donald Trump told pregnant women not to take Tylenol as his administration warned of an association with acetaminophen and autism.
I think the best answer that we have and that we can tell patients of ours confidently is that the really good science and good studies do not support that Tylenol causes autism. We do have decades of research showing that things like maternal fever and pain during pregnancy can have significant risks, including some developmental delays or differences. But no, there's no evidence of a causal relationship at this time.
Now, the number of children diagnosed with autism has been on the rise. Do researchers know why?
The newest prevalence rates, it has been increasing for prevalence has been increasing for the past 20 years. I think now we're at 1 in 31 is the most recent numbers. And there are many different reasons for that. But certainly there is not one cause. And I do just want to point out that the use of acetaminophen, Tylenol, has plateaued or decreased over the past 20 years. So it would be hard to explain the decrease in that with the increase in autism if there was a causal relationship.